Hello and welcome to a new Sales Card video tutorial. In this video, I'm going to guide you through the store import process and show you how it works. Say you have a shop running on Sales Card 306, everything's nice and proper, and here comes Sales Card 4 with some new features, one of them being, right, store import. Obviously, you'd like to upgrade because, well, that's progress. As a matter of fact, it's rather easy to do. What you're gonna need is your primary, currently working store, let's call it the primary store, and a clean, freshly installed on the same machine as your primary store, Sales Card 4. That'll be the new store. Now, what we're going to do is import all the data from my primary store, 306 Ultimate, into the new Sales Card 4 so that it could use and benefit from its cool features. First things first, since store import works as an add-on, log into the admin panel of your new Sales Card store and go to Add-ons, Manage Add-ons. Scroll down and find the store import add-on. Click Install. Seeing the notice, go to Add-ons and click Store Import. Now enter a full path to the directory of your primary store. In my case, the path is the following. Please note that the primary and the new store must be installed on the same host. Click Validate. Double check if everything is correct. If all is good, click Import Data. Sit back and wait until your data is imported. Depending on the amount of it, it might take either a couple of minutes or a couple of hours. As you can see, the initial data import is successfully completed. Everything I had in Sales Card 4 by default has been deleted and replaced with the data from my primary store. The peculiar thing about store import is that it doesn't transfer your store's design. So, on this step, you can leave this page and customize the look of your future store according to your needs, or reproduce your primary store's design. You can spend unlimited amount of time doing this. Your primary store will still work, receive orders, and sell normally. Pay attention to the text on this page. First of all, if you're an Ultimate user like me, prior to proceeding to customizing your store, you have to change the storefront URLs to the new ones, because now they are bound to the primary store and the error in the URLs may cause problems. Besides, you won't be able to customize your new store. Also, you have to go to the languages section and set the correct country value for each language. This will enable your new store to work properly. I'm going to switch to the theme editor built in Sales Card 4, which you can find under Design Themes in your admin panel, and reproduce the design of my primary store to use it in the new one now. Well, almost nailed it. Let's return to store import now and proceed directly to the next step by clicking this button. On this step, you can actualize data since the latest import. If your primary store is alive, up and running, you may need to actualize data. Actualizing data allows you to update your store since the initial data import. Actualizing data and store import are pretty much the same. You can actualize data as many times as is necessary. Let's click Actualize Data. Having actualized data, you will see this notice. Now, I'm ready to complete my store import. Well, that's pretty much it. Now, my Sales Card 4 looks very much like my primary store, both in and outside. I'm now ready to go live and sell happily. Well, that's it for today. We'll be happy to answer any questions you might have in the comment section below on Facebook and Twitter. Thanks for watching.